Hello and welcome to the interview here on France 24. Our guest today is a very busy man. He is the foreign minister of Turkey, Mevlüt Çavuşoğlu. Thank you very much for taking some of your precious time for an interview here on France 24. You have met here in Paris with your French counterpart, Laurent Fabius. You've been working the phones with colleagues from the Middle East and from Europe to deal mostly with the situation in Syria and especially the very alarming situation at the Syrian-Turkish border. The town of Kobane is under assault from the Organization of the Islamic State. Things are getting worse by the hour. I first want to ask you for your reaction to some declaration made by the UN Special Envoy for Syria, Stefan de Mistura, who urged Turkey to allow the Kurds who have taken refuge on your territory to be able to cross back into Syria with their equipment to try to prevent a massacre in Kobane. What is your reaction?
Well, the situation in Kobane actually is another example of the tragedy in Syria and in the region. And we have been following the situation very closely. And even in those difficult days, we have been delivering our humanitarian aid. And we have been keeping the open door policy for Syrian Kurds who had to flee from ISIL. And we receive more than 180,000, almost 200,000 Syrian Kurds so far. And the number has been increasing, actually. Now, I didn't follow this statement. But who wants to go back? These people, first of all, had to flee from terror and terrorist groups. I don't think those civilians want to go back. And Turkey cannot actually give weapons to the civilians and ask to go back and to fight with terrorist groups. We cannot actually risk the life of these people like this. Instead of this strategy, I think we need to have a predetermined strategy and comprehensive strategy. First of all, to stop ISIL and other terrorist groups and eradicate them from the region. This is more realistic.
Before we get to that strategy, so you're saying what the UN Special Envoy is saying is untrue, irresponsible?
No, this is not realistic. Who is going to supply the weapons to them? First of all, sending civilians to the war actually is a crime. We cannot do that.
So Turkey will not allow.
We don't want another tragedy in our region, and we cannot send those civilians who had to flee actually from terror. And Turkey is safe haven for them. And I don't think that those people, those civilians who actually had to flee, would prefer to go back in this area. Otherwise, they wouldn't.
Okay, coming to the strategy now. Turkey has been calling for a buffer zone and a no-fly zone along the Syrian border. You've recently received the support of France. In the United States, some parts of the government are saying it's worth considering. Others have said, no, we don't want to do this. You've had meetings with senior U.S. officials this week in Ankara. Is this making any progress? Is there a realistic chance of seeing this happening?
Well, we have been sharing our opinions in this case at every occasion. I participated to different meetings in Jeddah, in here Paris, hosted by, again, France, and in New York, and even in Wales during the NATO summit. And we need a comprehensive strategy. And Kobane is only part of the situation, actually, in Syria and in the region. And we have been counting all the elements of this comprehensive strategy, military and political ones, as well as humanitarian ones. Now, airstrikes, did it help? I don't think so. Now, can we say that airstrikes in Kobane region have been able to stop ISIL?
They failed.
They failed. So airstrikes can shift the balance a little bit, but it is not enough on alone to stop and to eradicate ISIL and the other terrorist groups. And killing the mosquitoes one by one actually is not a right strategy. we have to eradicate the root causes of this situation, which was Maliki regime in Iraq. That is, there has been a political transformation, more comprehensive government. Obviously, it is Assad regime in Syria. And we actually agree with France on this case as well.
That Assad needs to go.
Assad needs to go, and there should be a political transformation in Syria.
Without him.
Without him. And Geneva Declaration could be a very good basis on this.
Do you think the Obama administration still wants Assad to go? Because we don't hear American officials and European officials, by the way, calling for his ouster anymore. They believe he's actually won.
This is another problem, actually. Assad defenders has a firm policy, clear policy. Who is defending Assad? Iran and basically Russia. But allies doesn't have actually clear strategy on this.
Do you want them to clarify?
That's why in last 4 years, the situation has been getting worse and worse. Can we say that Assad is better than ISIL in this case? This regime killed more than 200,000 people, its own people. How? Through chemical weapons and barrel bombs, chlorine gas, airstrikes. They do not hesitate to take any measures actually to kill their own people.
Well, so what should happen in addition to this buffer zone, this no-fly zone? Do you believe this will happen? And you're also calling for a ground intervention because you're saying the airstrikes are not enough.
Well, as I ask, did airstrikes stop ISIL? No.
So you need ground forces.
Including ground forces, there should be a comprehensive predetermined strategy, including the political dimensions and political transformations in the ground. As long as Assad regime stays, we cannot talk about bringing stability, peace, and also security in the region. Today it is ISIL, and who was at the beginning? Al-Qaeda and Hezbollah. Then you heard other names. Now ISIL and Khorasan. And tomorrow it could be somebody else with similar ideology or different ideology.
Who should send ground troops? Will Turkey send ground troops? And if so, under which condition?
Well, if there is any agreed joint strategy, Turkey will seriously consider of the execution of this strategy with allies and with friendly countries.
So Turkey is ready to send ground troops into Syria?
If we agree on the strategy with the allies.
So this means the allies would also need to participate in such a ground strategy?
It is not fair asking only Turkey actually to lead the ground operation, and it's not realistic. And without a safe zone, and without a no-fly zone, it's not also very realistic.
From your consultations, are the allies moving towards a ground intervention in Syria?
Well, again, there is not an agreement on this strategy.
But is there progress towards
such? There is a progress. And France is supporting, in principle, the no-fly zone and safe zone.
And ground troops?
And ground troops also. Today, Fabius Laurent also openly said that just airstrike is not enough to stop or eradicate ISIL and other terrorist groups.
I want to get to the consequences in Turkey. As of today, 31 people died in clashes because the Kurds in your countries are not happy, to say the least, are furious in some cases because they believe you are punishing them by not intervening because they are Kurds. And what is your, do you understand their reaction?
I don't understand. There is a double standard of this. I'll come back. But first of all, I have to underline that we cannot discriminate regarding the people. They are all our neighbors and our relatives, our brothers and sisters. And we have been receiving Armenians, again Yazidis, Sunnis, Shias, Kurds, Arabs. And in last 3 weeks, we received almost 200,000 Syrian Kurds, as I said before.
Just the last question, because we're running out of time. Okay. You mentioned the PKK, the Kurdish Workers' Party. It's considered by Turkey as a terrorist group. Nevertheless, there are negotiations that have been taking place between your government and the PKK. The PKK said if Kobane falls, this is the end of the peace process. Do you believe the peace process is on its last legs with the PKK.
Why they didn't say this when ISIL advanced to other regions? Why?
Is it a real threat, or
and
do you believe
they also captured the predominantly Turkmen region and also Arab regions, our cities in that? We want to solve this problem. We are doing our best as the government to make this solution process successful. But nevertheless, for us, PKK is still terrorist group. Not only for us, they are in the terror list of the European Union and the United Nations.
But you're discussing with them. Are you still hoping
to
reach a deal?
We are doing not only discussing with them. We are not discussing with PKK. We are discussing this issue with all the elements of the society, and we are taking measures actually. But they still have not laid the weapons down. They are still active. They continue their terrorist activities. Unless they fully lay down the weapons and they give up the terrorist activities, they are terrorist groups. Now in Syria, different terrorist groups are fighting. PKK, PYD, ISIL, and others. Sometimes they fight with regime. Sometimes they fight between themselves for power. So can we say that this terrorist group is better, that one is worse? This is a wrong strategy. All of them are terrorist groups, and we cannot say my terrorist is good, that terrorist, your terrorist is worse or bad. This is a wrong strategy, I think.
Will you soon reach a time when you will have to decide that the PKK is not worth talking to anymore?
No, we will. We can never give up this process. We want to actually make achievements on this, and we are sincerely spending a lot of efforts. But they have to also do what they must do.
Okay. Thank you very much, Mr. Foreign Minister, for coming on the France 24 interview, and thank you for watching it here on France 24.